Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna do another Disney cruise series. So I have posted so many Disney cruise videos, so I hope you like it. I posted what to do before your Disney cruise and also our journey to Alaska with Disney Wonder this September. So I hope you like it, and if you do, make sure you like and subscribe and turn on the notification button, because I posted so many tips and tricks that I learned from doing a lot of research and from my experience as well. So I hope I can help other Disney cruisers as well. And today I'm gonna talk about weight gain. So I have been very excited about this Disney cruise for a long time, but I'm so worried and nervous at the same time, because I'm afraid I will gain a lot of weight. And if you watch my other video, which is how I lose 10 pounds fast and what I eat in a day to lose 6 kilos or 12 pounds, you know that I have thyroid issues. So every time I eat, I always gain so many weights, and after I'm doing a lot of stuff, finally I can lose a lot of weight. And every time I go to all-inclusive like Mexico, Cuba, Dominican Republic, and Jamaica, I always gain about 4 pounds, about 2 kilos. And as well as when we are going on a cruise during our honeymoon, I also gain weight. And because of my thyroid issue, after I give birth, I keep gaining weight easily. So I'm really excited about this Disney cruise, but I'm also worried and nervous at the same time. I've been starting to find a solution for my weight gain since July. So I've been swimming for 1 month almost every day in July, and starting in August I've been going to hot yoga almost every day, and I love it. I'm not really like a gym person or exercise person, I hate it, but turned out I really love it. And it's only 1 hour, and it's like a fusion, so it combines fitness and yoga, and I really really love that. Before my Disney cruise, I also watched a bunch of videos like how much do people gain during the cruise, and I guess it really depends on the people. Some people can gain a lot of weight, some people can gain less. So this video is inspired by Disney cruisers. I watch a lot of her videos before my cruise, so I think you're gonna love her video as well. So my cruise was on September 2nd, so about a month I've been doing hot yoga almost every day. So I start small before, like 2 times, 3 times, and I went there almost every day. It's just because I'm trying to lose weight, because I gained about 30 pounds. So I'm a bit nervous when I'm going to cruise. I know that they have a lot of good food, and I don't know whether I can stop eating, because during my in August I really watch what I eat, so I don't eat carbs at all. I only eat like fish and chickens and a lot of veggies, so I don't eat a lot of carbs. I don't eat sugars at all, like bubble tea. I used to love bubble tea. I usually drink like one bubble tea every day, or sometimes even two. So yeah, I know it's so bad, but before I didn't gain any weight so easy, but after the thyroid I gained so much weight. So let's say if I eat rice for dinner, I will gain 2 pounds for sure at night. So yeah, again, I'm really nervous about the cruise, and I'm worried whether if I gain the weight, can I lose the weight. So turn out before and after, I didn't gain weight at all. I know, it's a miracle, right? I always gain about 2 to 4 pounds every time I got back from all-inclusive holiday. So it's about 1 week, same like this, about 8 days, 7 nights. And all-inclusive is usually like that as well. And so in this video I'm gonna share what I did before and what I did during and what I did after. So I hope this video will help you. So for the preparation, first one, I went to hot yoga for almost every day. I didn't do this in purpose because of the cruise. I just did that because I was trying to lose weight. Again, I gained about 30 pounds. If you don't gain a lot of weight like me, you don't have to do that. But so far I weigh about 6 to 7 kilos, so about 12 to 14 pounds already. I still have about 16 pounds. So I still have 16 pounds, but I feel so much better. I feel lighter. So that's my first preparations. You can say preparation for the cruise. So for the second one, I didn't eat any carbs. I only drank like green juice in the morning, and I eat a lot of veggies. I like eat a lot of fish and breast chicken. So if you're curious, you can watch my previous video, which is how I lose the 10 pounds fast. I tried everything before. I tried Zumba. It didn't work. I tried to cut sugar and bubble tea. It didn't work. I tried to I tried to eliminate the rice. It didn't work. So turned out I had food sensitivity, which is soya and egg. So I tried to change my soya sauce as well to the gluten-free one, and I can see that my weight go down drastically. So watch. So if you have a weight issue, you can watch that video. And again, I just want to remind you, I gained 0 pounds, which is really a miracle because I prepared myself to gain about 4 pounds like usual, but I didn't get any. I didn't gain any weight, but I must say that I can see like my face getting chubbier and my tummy is getting bigger, and I feel like so much heavier. I was planning to do exercise every day. They have like a free gym, they have free yoga sessions, they have free spinning class, they have free FABS apps. Unlike other cruises, these classes are free because I know that other cruises sometimes charge about 20 US dollar, but this one is absolutely free. Unfortunately, there's just so many things to do, and Brandon usually wake up early in the morning, so I have to bring him to breakfast and then go to the kids club open house. So I only went to the gym for the yoga session once, so I didn't get any weight, but I can say that my face and my tummy is getting chubbier. You can see my before cruise pictures and my after cruise pictures, and that's my preparation. So first one, I went to hot yoga almost every day. Second one, I watch what I eat because I've been trying to lose weight for couple months already. So I drank lemon water. I only ate or drank green juice. I don't eat rice. I don't eat any sugars. But during the cruise, I eat a lot. So breakfast, I even eat carbs because breakfast and lunch at Cabanas, they have a really yummy Chinese noodles. I love that. It tastes like Indonesian's noodles, so I really love it. And I also eat about 3 to 4 or 5 desserts at night during the fine dining, during the sit down dinner. And I also eat steak, I also eat lobster and king crab. So on the first day during the dinner, I asked for lemon for my water. And again, what's fabulous about Disney is that they have something that I call dining rotations. So we changed to 3 main restaurant, which is Trident, Animator's Palette, and Tiana's Place. And the servers and the assistant server and the head server is always there. Like whenever we change a restaurant, they're always there. And he asked me, oh, so you like lemon with your water? And every night when I come to dinner, they always have the lemon ready for my water. So it's really awesome. And then I always try to take stairs. So we stayed on the 5th floor if I'm going to gym or I want to walk around during the to deck 9 or deck 10, or when I walk around, I try to take the stairs instead of the elevators. And sometimes elevators, you need to wait for the elevator as well. And then I always try to take stairs with Brandon because I need to burn his energy because he's really active. But if we are in hurry, let's say, because I stayed at 5th floor F, which is at the back, and then we eat breakfast at Cabanas, which is at F as well, we will take the elevator. And that's why I really love my stateroom and the location. So I'm gonna make another video about my stateroom and how much we paid for the cruise, so stay tuned for that. Sometimes if we are in hurry and Brandon just couldn't stand still, we just take the elevator because it's so much faster. But I try to take stairs whenever it is possible. And sometimes when he's taking a nap or during his bedtime, when I take turn with my husband to take a tour on the ships, I always take the stairs. And what's amazing about the stairs as well, you can see other staterooms on the 6th floor, 7th floor, 8th floor, 9th floor. You can see the magnet decorations on the door, and I love that. People are so creative. They also have like a really nice pouch for the face extenders. So I highly recommend to take the stairs if you can. And again, regarding the exercise, I was planning to do gym every day, to do the elliptical, to do the treadmill, to join all the classes because it's free. But I just went once because I just didn't have time. There's a lot of activities that I can do, and I prefer to do that instead of going to the gym, to be honest. And I was planning to do jogging as well on the deck 4, because they have because on deck 4 it's really amazing, you can walk around. But because it's only one floor down, I can just take the stairs, but I only did that once. So I don't really watch what I eat, but I really only eat that what I love. So something that I don't really love, I put it aside. So for example, during the breakfast, I tried the muffin, I tried the pastry like the croissant and donuts. I'm not a big fan of that, so I still eat carbs, but I don't eat like the pastry because it just doesn't taste amazing. And for breakfast, I'm not a big fan of the breakfast at the Cabanas as well. I love the lunch, so I try to limit what I eat during breakfast time, but I eat more during the lunch time. And last time, every day I eat seafood, a lot of seafood, mussels and crab, and also the fresh shrimp. I really really love it. I eat a lot every day because they have that. I don't think other cruises have that during the lunch buffet. They only have it during the dinner. So yeah, since I was a kid, I always love fresh food, so I will not miss that. I also eat carbs, and they have a nice congee, they have a nice noodles, they have like steak, salmons, and lots of veggies as well. But I always eat desserts. Sometimes they have a really nice cakes. They have a lot of sections, but I'm not a big fan as well. I think about 2 or 3 times I eat the dessert for the cakes. But what I really love is the chocolate chip cookie and then warm chocolate pudding, and then combined with the ice cream is really really good. And almost every day they change the flavor of the ice cream. So sometimes they have vanilla, they have cookies and cream, dulce, I don't know the name, but they keep changing the flavor. And my favorite is still chocolate. Rocky Mountain, I think, is the chocolate is really good, and cookies and cream. So combine that with the chocolate chip cookie. So the chocolate chip cookie is really warm, and the cookies and the chocolate chip just melt in your mouth, and especially with the ice cream, it just tastes so good. And the chocolate warm pudding is really good as well. I always combine it with ice cream as well. So I eat that almost every day. And what I'm trying to skip is the ice cream machines on deck 9. So everybody rave about it. Everybody say it's really good. They keep changing the flavor every day. They have about 3 machines there. They have chocolate vanilla, they have blueberry, they have pina colada, they have strawberry, and it keeps changing. I tried, I'm not a big fan, so I tried that once only. But instead, I tried to eat something that I really love, which is during the lunchtime, and the ice cream. And I tried the cookies at the Daisy Delight as well. They have the chocolate chip cookie, but it just tastes different. So I highly recommend to eat the chocolate chip cookie and ice cream at Cabanas during the lunch time. And of course, don't skip any desserts at the sit-down restaurant. It's just really good. So we only have 2 adults and 1 toddler, but we always order 3 to 5 desserts every night, and also order the Mickey bar with the Mickey sprinkles for Brandon. He's obsessed with that. I'm gonna also make another video about what is the best appetizer, what is the main course, what is the best desserts for each restaurant and at Cabanas, so you don't need to waste your calories on the food that is not really good. I can say that almost everything is really good at Disney Cruise. Like, I tried with other cruise line before, I can eat it, I feel like it's good, but it's just like not great. But sometimes when you eat at Disney Cruise, it's just really nice. Like the steak, they cook it perfectly, and the dessert is just really really good. Sometimes lunch, you can also go to Tritons, which is the sit-down restaurant. You can order from the appetizer, main course, and dessert. But sometimes during the main course, I'm not a big fan of rice now or potato. I will ask them to prepare the fish only, like salmon and sable fish, and leave the fish, the rice out or the potato out. But sometimes if I feel like I want to try the potato, sometimes really good, I will order the potato. So I rather leave a space for dessert instead of like the potato or carbs. I just want to make this video because I know a lot of people is like me. It's really nervous, like so excited for the cruise, but really worried about the weight gain. Well, I would say that don't worry, because after you come back, you will not eat a lot like lunch, like at the cruise, because during the cruise time you eat breakfast and you're still so full, and then it's gonna be lunch time already and you're still full, and then you can still eat pizza or ice cream or other snacks on deck 9. You're still full, and then it's a main seating time already, like the 5:45, and then yeah, so you're not hungry yet, but you still keep eating. But at home, you will not eat like that. At the beginning, you will struggle because your stomach is already used to it, to eat a lot. But don't worry. It took me about 2 weeks. So again, it's a miracle I didn't gain weight. But I feel like chubbier here and there. And my body is not as toned as before I go to cruise. But don't worry, after 2 weeks, my body lose the weight, my face becomes smaller again. So don't worry, just enjoy your cruise and eat what you want and what you love. I would say try to eliminate the one that you don't like. So try to just put it aside, something that you don't want. And but again, don't waste food. So if you can, just try to ask them to eliminate the potato and rice, if for sure you will not eat it. Oh, one thing that I'm worried about as well is for the soda, because Disney Cruise, unlike others, you don't need to pay, or I would say is already included on your cruise price for the sodas. Is all you can drink during the sit down, and you can also get it, it's unlimited on deck 9. But I'm not a big fan of soda, but every night I still drink lemonade. So lemonade is like a soda, right? So they will bring me lemonade because they know I love lemonade and lemon water. They will put it on my table already, it's ready every night. But again, I gained zero weight. I didn't drink any alcohol because I'm not a big fan of alcohol. So if you love alcohol, I would say be careful as well. But again, if you already pay for it, just enjoy it. If you love it, why not? And again, so miracle can happen. You can gain zero weight, 0 pounds, 0 kilos. But if you gain weight, don't worry. I would say just enjoy your cruise, have fun, because you already pay so much for the cruise. Just trying to relax, don't think about the weight. If you don't have time to exercise, don't worry about it. You can always fix the damage afterwards. That's what I would say. So I'm gonna put the picture before, I'm before, during, then after. So I still working on my weight gain, because again, I gained so many weight because of the thyroid issue. Again, I lose some of it already. I still need to work on half of it. So, I hope you like this video, and stay tuned for my other video. And thanks for watching, guys. Bye.